Hey, what's up guys? So in this video, we're gonna be taking a look at both radar detectors and Waze. We're gonna be taking a look at the pros and cons of each, which one you should run, if one can replace the other, and ultimately what the best setup is gonna be. Now, I see questions all the time. People are wondering, why should I run a radar detector if I already have Waze? Waze is free and already alerts me to police officers, and that's a great point, but it turns out each one has strengths and weaknesses, and what's interesting is the weakness of one is oftentimes compensated by the other, so believe it or not, your best setup a lot of times is not just gonna be running one or the other, but actually both at the same time. Now, starting off with radar detectors real quick, they're not police car detectors, they're radar detectors. And the idea is, if an officer is running a radar gun like this, and if they want to clock oncoming traffic up ahead, they can just grab their gun, fire up the radar gun, and it's going to tell them the speed of oncoming traffic like this. And then, of course, any nearby radar detectors are going to get alerted that radar is actively being used. Police officers run radar a lot of times with both front and rear-facing antennas. Now, Waze is a little bit different. Instead of trying to detect the officer's radar guns, if you're driving by and you notice there's an officer on the side of the road, you can just go in the app and mark that an officer is there, and then other drivers will get alerted. Similarly, as you're approaching an officer, you'll get alerted to other people's notifications, so it's a big cloud-sourced notification alert system. Now, there's definitely going to be pros and cons to each. With radar detectors, for example, these are awesome at giving you long-range alerts. You can easily get alerts a mile to 3 miles plus. I've seen 10-mile alerts before in ideal situations. One of the downsides, though, is you're going to be getting some false alerts. Like, for example, you'll notice my detector is starting to false here to some of the shopping center automatic door openers. Additionally, some newer cars have radar-based collision avoidance systems, and those can cause radar detectors to false alert as well. In fact, Doug DeMuro, one of my favorite YouTubers, did an article a couple years ago comparing the two, and this was his big complaint about radar detectors. It was the fact that, well, these things are going to false alert, and that's true. Luckily, the newer ones do have some nice filters to help filter those out, things like maybe GPS to filter out door openers and whatnot, or they're more advanced and sophisticated, able to filter out a lot of nearby cars. Every detector is still going to false to some extent, but the newer detectors are better than a lot of the older detectors. And then Waze, as I mentioned, it's totally different. It's an app you can run on your phone, and you can report where police are located, and you get notified of other people's reports. Plus, it's a nice and popular app, so they actually offer Apple CarPlay and Android Auto integration as well. So if you see an officer, you can just go over here into the app, and then you can just mark, hey, police spotted, and report it right here, which is very convenient. Now, Waze is going to work best in populated areas because you're going to need a lot of drivers to go in and drive around and report when officers are now stopped in a certain area. Additionally, Waze is going to work best, well, actually only work, against stationary threats. So an officer is parked on the side of the road, Waze is going to be perfect for that. If an officer is moving and they're running radar like I am, Waze is not unfortunately going to be useful at all. Somebody could, of course, mark that there's an officer in this spot right now, but they're going to be gone 10, 20 seconds from now anyway, so that alert is really not going to be useful. And so basically, you're going to be getting alerted to officers that are parked on the side of the road and that have been there for a little while, giving people enough time to actually report that he's there so that you can get alerted when you come by next. This is then going to bring us to some of the downsides of Waze. If you come up to an officer who just arrived and hasn't been reported yet, you're not going to get any advance notification. Additionally, if the officer doesn't want to be reported in the app, they can try to be hidden. They can maybe kind of go hide off in the woods a little bit. They can sometimes hang out on highway overpasses or highway on-ramps and tag people from behind. Or maybe it's just nighttime, and so it's really hard to see police officers in the first place and mark them in the app, especially if they have their lights off. So for that reason, Waze is going to work best when people can actually see the officers and when you have a lot of people coming by. Additionally, because Waze is an app that requires cell service, you're going to want to be in major cities. It may not work when you're driving through smaller towns or taking road trips or something. I've also run into issues if I drive up to Canada and I don't have international roaming data, for example. Waze doesn't help there. But if you're doing most of your typical driving just around town or on highways and kind of urban areas, Waze will be great for that. Now, the biggest limitation that I find with Waze is the fact that it only works on officers who are stationary. If they're moving, if they're running radar while driving, Waze is not going to help for that. I see a lot of that myself, and for that reason, I definitely need to still run a radar detector, even though Waze is a great add-on. Now, if anything, Waze is actually going to be more useful against officers running laser than it will if they're running radar. Now, the reason that's the case is that if an officer is running a laser gun, they can only do this when stationary. You can't exactly do this while also trying to drive, right? Plus, laser guns themselves only support stationary operation. They have no moving mode capabilities at all. So laser can only be done when an officer is stationary, which again is going to be great for Waze. Additionally, laser jammers are going to be more expensive than radar detectors. The installation is much more involved. They are prohibited in certain states. Plus, it's not going to be as easy to maybe toss one into a rental car or something as you're traveling. The way it would be with maybe a radar detector, you could just stick on the windshield. But the main advantage is going to come from the fact that officers have to be stationary when they're running laser, unlike radar, which can be run both stationary or moving. Additionally, the way people actually report the officer in the app can make a difference. If the officer's set up shooting laser and they've got nice long line of sight, Waze is only going to give you a half mile of advanced warning, and it's definitely possible to where the officer can hit you with laser before you get the alert from Waze. Additionally, the way Waze works, if somebody's driving down the road and they see an officer, and then it may take them a quarter mile to actually go into the app and mark the officer. So for that reason, the alert is going to be a little bit behind where the officer actually is, which shortens your alert distance. And so I find that even against laser, Waze is not going to be a suitable, reliable substitute. It's a great add-on, and it's more helpful against officers running laser, but I definitely find that laser jammers are still very helpful and necessary. Waze is not going to be a suitable alternative. And then as far as false alerts, I find that Waze is pretty good about this. If you come across an officer who's previously been marked and now he's no longer there, Waze actually has an option in the app to mark that the officer is no longer there, which is pretty cool. Now that said, I can't tell you how many times I've been driving down the highway with a Waze alert up ahead, expecting to get shot with laser or something, so I've got my hand on the kill switch ready to disable my laser jammers. But it turns out this was just a false alert too, and so I wind up marking in the app that the officer is no longer there. So yeah, Waze definitely has its own share of false alerts too. In fact, I've seen more false alerts from Waze than legitimate alerts, but of course your mileage may vary. Now, I've heard a lot of people concerned about what happens if officers maybe set up on the side of the road, set up a speed trap, and they're also running Waze, and people mark them, and they just go into the app and say, I'm no longer here. What about that? That's a great question. Even though officers can and do that sometimes, I don't think it's a huge issue in practice. The way Waze works is it's going to be looking for multiple people to report and confirm something. So let's say an officer sitting on the side of the road and says, I'm not there in the app. Well, everybody else coming by is going to say, well, yes, the officer is still here. And so therefore, the alert is going to stay and remain in the app. Additionally, Waze is going to see that this user, their reports are not very accurate. They report something, but everybody else is saying something else. And because of that, it's going to start to kind of weigh down their reports and make them not as important as somebody whose accuracy is going to be higher. Additionally, if an officer wants to drive around and just start reporting, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here, but there's no actual officer there, people are going to drive by and say, there's no officer here. So again, that's going to be affecting the accuracy of their reports, which is going to factor in terms of long-term reporting in general. So that's a concern, but I don't think that's a huge issue in practice. And so when it comes to all the different countermeasures, what I find works best and what I do myself is I run a radar detector, I run Waze, and I run my laser jamming system. This is going to give me nice protection against all of them. No one option is going to be giving you protection in all situations, and heck, running all three, it's not going to mean you're going to be completely bulletproof or anything, but the odds definitely get stacked much higher in your favor once you start getting multiple layers of protection instead of relying on just one to keep you completely protected. And then if you need any recommendations about my favorite radar detectors or my favorite laser jammers, I'll drop links in the video description. And then finally, I'm also curious to hear from you guys. I know a lot of you also run Waze. You also run radar detectors and whatnot. I'm curious about your countermeasures. Do you find that one is more helpful than the other? Do you find that maybe most of your saves come from your radar detector, or maybe most of the saves come from Waze? Let me know. I'm curious to hear kind of which countermeasures you found to be most helpful, and if you think you could get away with maybe just running one or the other, if one could be a complete replacement. In my opinion, I don't think so, but other people, maybe that is your experience. So I'm kind of curious. Let me know down in the comments. Other than that, yeah, thanks so much for watching. I know this is something that people have been asking all the time, so it's always fun to do videos about that and just kind of answer this in detail so that we can all go over this together. So awesome. Thanks again. I'll see you in the next video.